Hello again, this is Dr. Lindsay. What we're going to do in this video is calculate how to calculate the profit or loss for a firm, and we'll do it graphically. So remember, the profit is equal to the total revenue minus the total cost. And total revenue is price of the product times the output Q. And the total cost is the average cost of each unit produced, which is the average total cost, times the quantity that's produced. And the average total cost is going to depend on what quantity that we produce. Now we can write this also as the quantity times the price minus the average total cost. And our profit maximizing position would be a quantity of Q star, where Q star, remember, is going to be where price equals marginal cost. Or we can also write that as where the marginal revenue equals the marginal cost. Now you can see on here that if we're going to be making a positive profit, then the price that we're charging has to be greater than our average total cost. So if we're making 10 units at a price of $7 each on average, we better be selling it for more than $7 in order to make a profit. Otherwise, if it's less than $7, we're going to be losing money. So graphically, let's draw what's going on. We'll put cost over here on the vertical axis, and we'll put quantity down on this axis. And remember, the average total cost has this U shape to it. And we've got a marginal cost curve that comes up and intersects that average total cost curve right at its lowest point. Now, in a perfectly competitive industry, there's a market price for this product. The company is a price taker. And let's say that price is right here, P star, right here. I'm going to draw a line like this, horizontal line at P star. And we know that the profit maximizing quantity, that Q star for the firm to set, is where price equals marginal cost. So that means we want to look right here where price is equal to marginal cost, that point there, and come down directly. And that quantity there, that is Q star. That is the profit maximizing point for this firm to produce. Now, what is their total revenue? It's P star times Q. It's this box here outlined in red. That big rectangle, that's our total revenue. Price times quantity. What's the total cost? Well, to figure out what our costs are at Q star per unit, our average cost, we would go straight up here until we hit the average total cost curve right here. It's not at the bottom necessarily. And how much is that? Well, we go over here to the cost axis, and that's our average total cost at the quantity Q star. So our total costs are going to be that point here, on the cost curve, times the quantity. So if I draw the total costs here, it'll be this rectangle right here. The total revenue was price times quantity. The profit is equal to total revenue minus total cost. So that means the profit has to be this area right here, this rectangle here in blue. This is the profit. Down here, this rectangle here in the pink, these are the costs. The sum of the two rectangles together is the total revenue, price times quantity. So we take that total revenue, subtract off the total cost, and what's left over there in blue is the profit. Okay, so in this example, the firm made money. That's great. And if the firm is going to make money, then that price has to be above the average total cost curve. So the price is greater than our average total costs, then there's a profit. But what if price is less than average total cost? Well, if the price is less than the average total cost, then there's going to be a loss. And if the price happens to be exactly equal to the average total cost, it's not a loss, but it's not a profit. That's at the point we're going to say that's zero profit. Now let's take a look at each one of these cases. Okay, in the first case, case one, price is above average total cost and there's a profit. This is the one that we just went through here and the graph is above. What about here where the price is less than average total cost? What's that going to look like? Okay, so here's the cost here and here is quantity. We've got this U-shaped curve. Average total cost curve. We have this marginal cost curve. And if the price happens to be somewhere down here, let's say P star is here. The firm is going to try to maximize their profits. They're going to set price equal to marginal cost. And that's going to be right here where this blue line intersects the marginal cost curve. The optimal quantity for them to produce will be right here at Q star. Total revenue will be price times quantity. That's going to be this area right here. But what about total costs? If we draw the box here for total costs, we're going to, at Q star, we're going to have to go up to the average total cost curve to figure out what our costs are on average for each unit. We go over here. And the total costs are going to be this rectangle here. And you can see that total cost rectangle is greater than the total revenue. That means there's some loss going on here. So I'll put that in green. This shaded area right here in green represents the loss to the firm. Now, at a different Q star, the losses would actually be greater. So that Q star, it's minimizing the losses. Remember, this Q star is just the optimal point given the price. But the Q star in each one of these is different. So in the first one here, you can see that Q star was actually at a point that's higher than the bottom of the average total cost curve. And here, this Q star is a different number too. We call it Q star because it's optimal, but that optimal amount depends on the price and the marginal cost curve. So Q star here is a number, but it's not the same in every single case. So at different prices, Q star is going to be a different number.